Assalamualaikum guys, welcome back to Civil Engineers YouTube channel with the new lecture. Guys, today in this important video lecture, I'm gonna talk about basic rules for lapping length in RCC column. This topic is very interesting and it is very important for every civil engineering student, but especially for site engineering student, it's very important to know about what is lapping length, where we provide lapping length, what's the length of lapping length, etc. Okay, and what are the basic rules for lapping length? So especially it's very important for every civil engineering students, but if you are working on construction site, so you should know about the basic knowledge for lapping length in RCC column or for beam or in slab, etc. So this is the topic for today, basic rules for lapping length in RCC column. So let's start guys. If this video is helpful for you, so don't forget to like this video and subscribe the channel with press bell icon if you are new. As you can see guys, this is these two are longitudinal bars in RCC column. Suppose this is a column. My diagram is not good, but I will try to make something for you people. This is RCC column, okay, and these black color lines showing you here longitudinal bars. So what is lapping length guys? This is called lapping length. This length is called lapping length. This is lapping length, LL, lapping length. Why we provide lapping length in RCC column and beam and slab, etc., especially in steel structure? Because guys, we have standard length of steel bar, that is 12 meter from factory, steel factory. Standard length of steel bar is 12 meters. So sometimes we need more length. So there we need lapping length. That's why, because for example, if we have a steel bar, that is for example, if this is 5 meter one steel, okay, and we required total 8 meter length. Now guys, we required the other steel bar to get, this is total 8 meters, okay, and we have 5 meters. So here we required guys 3 meter more length. So here we will overlap one steel bar with other like this, okay, then we will get, so we overlap one steel bar to another. This is called lapping length, to get full length, because this is 5 meter and we will overlap 3 meter more steel, then we can get 8 meter. So guys, for insufficient steel bar, we overlap one steel bar to another to get full length for any structure, if that is column, beam or slab, etc. So therefore we provide lapping length. This is the first point. Now guys, what are the basic rules for lapping length in RCC column? Here guys, the first rule is, and you should know these rules which I am telling you in this video, that is, if dia of steel bar, dia of steel bar is more than 36 millimeters, so we should not provide lapping length, okay. So more than 36 millimeter dia should not provide lapping length. This is the first rule. If the dia of steel bar, for example, if this steel bar dia is more than 36 millimeter, so we should not provide lapping length, because it can make a problem. Okay, this is the first rule. Guys, the second rule is, if guys, for example, this is one steel bar, which dia is, for example, 24 millimeters. Okay, dia is 24 millimeter, and the other steel bar we are overlapping, this one, and this is, for example, 20 millimeters. And now we will overlap this, because for example, if the formula is, because we have different formulas for lapping length in RCC column from IS code and from other reference, okay. So the formula is here, for example, 50D. Now here D shows here dia of steel bar, right? So there is a question, and it's very important for you people. This is often asked question in interview. So now this is the base dia is 24 millimeter and the top dia is 20 millimeter, this one, okay. So now which one dia we will take for lapping length? Got it? This question, we have two dias. The base dia is 24 millimeters and the top bar is 20 millimeters. So now the dia 50D, D shows the dia of steel bar. Now we will get this length, okay. So which one dia we will take to get lapping length, because D show dia of steel bar. So guys, we will take lesser dia, this one, 20 millimeters. That's why, because it's already okay, the base dia and steel bar is okay, but we overlap the top one, so therefore the top one dia we should take for lapping length. This is the second rule, okay. So for lapping length, it is very important, okay. For lapping length, take lesser dia of steel. Now guys, for lapping length, take lesser dia of steel bar in the case of this equation. If there are two dias, if there is one dia, for example 12 millimeter and other is also 12 millimeter, are two dias, two steel bar dia is same, so there we don't require, because there is a same dia. If the dia is changed, so we will take there the top bar which we are overlapping, so that dia we will take for get lapping length. This is the second rule. Now guys, there is also the one other question from IS. The reference is IS 13920-2003 and the clause number 6.2.6. In this clause, they said, because there are two lapping length, because in RCC column we required lapping length for, if there are four steel bars or six steel bars or 12 steel bars, so we will take lapping length. So here guys, you can see this one, and from the center of lapping length, okay, so this distance should be this distance. From one lapping center to other lapping center, the distance should be 1.3 times of length. For example, if the dia is 25 millimeter dia, if I am using 25 millimeter dia in this, for example, if this dia is 25 millimeters, it is very important to understand about this, okay. 25 millimeter is a dia of steel bar. Now I am using here the formula 50D. So now the lapping length should be here. What? Lapping length should be 50 multiplied D is what? 25. Okay? 25. So it will give us 1270 millimeters, okay. So the length should be 1270 millimeters. But here is a question, if lapping length is, for example, 1 meter, okay, so it will become, this is 1270, so it will be multiplied with 1.3, so this should be, we will get this one if anything comes. So the distance should be 1.3 times of lapping length. For example, if lapping length is, for example, lapping is if the lapping is 1 meter. Okay, so we will take the spacing here 1.3 meters. Okay, from one lapping center to other lapping center, it is very important. Okay, because lapping length should not be provided at the same point. So therefore, from one center of lapping to the other center of lapping, distance should be 1.3 times of lapping length. For example, if lapping length is, for example, 2 meters, so the space should be from one center to other, that should be 2.6, because 1.3 times it should be increased. For example, if lapping length is 1 meter, so from this center to this center means this length should be 1 meter and 300 millimeters. Okay, yes, 300 millimeters. Okay, or 1.3 meters. So this is the point. And IS 13920:2003, clause number 6.2.6. Now, guys, to take proper lapping. Okay, so we will tilt here. If this is a steel bar, okay, so it should become, we should bend this like this. Okay, so it will come here, it will joint. Okay, so like this. Okay, then we will provide steel bar here. So this dia for tilt, okay, for this tilt. Okay, so this tilt length we can get with 6d. D is dia of steel bar, so 6 multiply, for example, 25 millimeter is a dia, so we can get this one, this length. Okay, it's very important. So the third point is, sorry, the fourth one is, the first one is lapping length center distance should be 1.3 times of lap length. This is the other rule. And the fourth rule is tilt steel especially for lapping length, that should be with the formula of 6D to get proper lapping. Okay, so guys, these are some helpful points and rules for lapping length, why we provide lapping length and how we can take lapping length, and what should be the distance for from one center to other center for lapping length, and also where we provide lapping length, and lapping length should not be provided more than 36 millimeter die of steel bars, etc. Okay, and which one length we will take for the lapping length if there are two dias of steel bar. So guys, this is the important topic which I have discussed the front of you. If there is any question related with this topic, so you can comments, I will try to reply your answer. Thanks for watching. See you in next video. Goodbye.